Hello and welcome to the JBNM Sports Fanatic channel. Thank you for joining me for this video. And so we've got some Melvin Ingram updates here. Apparently, the Steelers are hosting the veteran who's been in the league for 9 years, all with the Chargers dating back to 2012, which was his rookie season. He's made the Pro Bowl 3 of the last 4 seasons, exception being last year. But overall, he's a tremendous asset that really, you know, if the Steelers are able to bring him in, that would be a great fit for them in terms of just, you know, bolstering that position, adding that extra pass rusher there. And they've got a tremendous defense already, you know, even going back to last season and everything they were able to accomplish. So adding someone like him could be really big and help the Steelers, especially when you have teams like, you know, the Baltimore Ravens and Lamar Jackson, as well as the Cleveland Browns this year. Who'd have thought we'd be talking about the Browns in this way? And not to mention the Bengals, you know, they should be improved as well, you know, especially if Joe Burrow takes that next leap. So certainly having pass rushers would be extremely key. Now, he did receive some interest from the Kansas City Chiefs, and that obviously makes sense for why the Chiefs would be interested, as well as the Miami Dolphins. So those are some interesting, you know, good teams right there, all contenders on this list for Ingram to, you know, go through. But he's going to be having that infield visit today, and so we'll see how that goes. And if they're able to come away with some type of contract in place, that would really bode well for the Steelers. When you take a look at the Steelers' current roster right now, obviously when you talk about this defense, it starts with T.J. Watt and what he brings. But they've got a lot of guys on this defense. I mean, aside from him, you know, there's Devin Bush. And then you look in the secondary, there's Minka Fitzpatrick. Now, they've got some pieces on this defense. You know, Joe Hayden, Cameron Haywood, they've got some pieces on this defense. So this would be, if I'm him and I'm looking at it from a defensive perspective, it certainly would make sense to join a team like the Pittsburgh Steelers and add that pass rush to what they've already got there. But we'll see what he decides. You know, hopefully things will go well there. In terms of what he's been able to do in his entire career so far, dating back to 2012, he has started 96 of the 113 games that he has suited up for. And so he's been very durable. Matter of fact, every game that he's pretty much suited up for, he's been a starter since 2014. And in terms of production, he has a career total of 360 tackles, along with 49 sacks that has been throughout his entire career, and 7 fumble recoveries, along with 14 forced fumbles and 3 interceptions. And so, his best season, statistically speaking, could have arguably been in 2015 when he had 65 tackles and 10.5 sacks. He did not make the Pro Bowl that year, but from 2017 to 2019, he made the Pro Bowl each of those years. And in 2017, he also had 10.5 sacks with 56 tackles that year. And so he's certainly someone that can for sure get after the quarterback. And I'm excited to see where this new opportunity is going to be, because he's been with the Chargers his entire career. So obviously a different system. Hey, maybe that might be, you know, what he needed, a different scenario. But we'll see how that works out. And excited for him. And we'll see if something comes into fruition for the Steelers. But if they do come into some type of an agreement, you can be sure to find it here. So make sure that you like this video and press the subscribe button if you have not already. Best way for me to keep you up to date with what's transpiring in the NFL, NBA, and college athletics as well. But with that being said, thank you guys so much for joining me, and see you guys next time.